SS720. The auditor's responsibilities relating to other information. So, what is this other information? The company publicly issues its annual report at the year end after AGM, and the annual report contains financial statement and audit report, which means financial statement and audit report are part of annual report which is made public by the company. So when people or general public read the annual report and it contains financial statement and audit report, the public has a mentality that the audit, that the information contained in annual report is also overlooked, also looked and verified by the auditor. Keeping this in mind, this SS720 came into effect. So just because the audit report and financial statement, audit report is a part of annual report, the public has the mentality that the annual report is also being audited or checked by the auditor. So for this purpose, SS720 has affected. The other information. The other information can be financial as well as non-financial. It does not matter that whether it is finance, only it can be financial. Annual report contains everything regarding its branch, head office, and future perspective and various other matters. So SS720, the auditor's responsibilities relating to other information, deals with auditor's responsibility relating to other information, whether financial or non-financial information included in the entity's annual report. So, what this essay covers? This essay requires auditors to first see what information is being included. Again, consider whether it is appropriate, and third, if there is a deviation, then report on the same. So, first of all, annual report. Annual report is issued after the audit is completed and auditor has signed audit report. So, in this case, the auditor has to obtain the information regarding the other information. So how can he do that? Because the annual report is prepared after the audit is completed. Because there are many figures that need to be updated in annual report, which can be based on the audited financial statement presented by the auditor, various figures. In this case, the first thing that SS720 requires is that to obtain the other information. So the auditor shall first. How auditor can collect the other information? Auditor can collect the other information as it as the information is published after the audit. So auditor can collect the other information by three ways. First, by discussing with management what information are to be included in the annual report and what documents should be part of the annual report. Either auditor can discuss with the management and get the information, or second, where appropriate, if appropriate, if possible, auditors should ask the management to provide the draft annual report so he can see it, verify it before the final version is published. Or if the annual report cannot be made available before the finalization of the audit, that means before signing of audit report, then auditor should obtain a written representation from management that the audit annual report should be made available to the auditor when it is finalized, before making it public. So the auditor can obtain information about other information in three ways. First, either he can discuss with management about the information to be included or document to be included in the annual report. Or if possible, the auditor should ask the draft annual report before its finalization, before finalization of audit report. Or third, if audit report annual report is not possible, not available before the finalization of audit, the auditor should obtain written representation from management that the annual report other information shall be available to auditor when it is finalized before publicly issuing making it public. And once the information is gathered by the auditor should consider the other information, that is matter contained in other information. What should auditor consider? This is the second requirement of SS720. SS720 first requires the collection of information. It specifies the method of collection information, which we discussed today. And once information is collected, it specifies how to consider it, how to verify it. So, when the information is collected, the auditor shall first consider whether the information mentioned, whether financial or non-financial, mentioned in the annual report is materially misstated. First, auditor has to consider whether the information, other information mentioned in the annual report is materially inconsistent with the other information. To evaluate, so the auditor can do the test basis. The auditor can select the figures from the financial statement on test basis and compare with the annual report. And second, the auditor should also consider that the information mentioned in the other information, to the best of the information gathered, by the auditor during the audit, to the knowledge of the auditor, is if it consistent or materially inconsistent. And third, if there is some material inconsistent, then the auditor shall request the management to correct the other information. And if the management agrees to make the correction, the auditor shall determine that the correction has been made. And if the management refuses to make the correction, the auditor shall communicate the matter with those charged with governance and request the correction to be made. And if what if correction is not made? So again, I am discussing in small point. As a 720, the auditor's responsibilities relating to other information requires first auditor to collect information. How he can collect information? First matter, he can discuss with management about what information is to be included in annual report, what document will form part of the annual report. Or if possible, the auditor should ask management to produce draft annual report before finalization of audit. Or if a draft annual report is not available, the auditor should take written representation from management that the audit annual report will be made available to the auditor when it is prepared before making it to public. And once audit annual report other information is received by the auditor, the auditor should consider following. First, consider whether the information contained in the other information is inconsistent with the figure of the financial statement. He can do so by checking the various figure on test basis. And also he should consider whether the information, whether financial or non-financial, mentioned in the annual report to the best of the knowledge to the knowledge of the auditor obtained during the audit is consistent. If the information other information is not consistent either with the financial statement or with the knowledge obtained by the auditor during the audit, the auditor shall require the management to make the correction in the information. And if the management agrees to make the correction, the auditor shall determine the correction, determine that a correction has been made. And if the management refuses to make the correction, the auditor shall communicate with those charged with governance and request that the correction is made. And even though the correction is not made, and auditor concludes that the misstatement is material in nature, that the material misstatement exists in other information obtained, that if the information, either the information can be obtained before the audit report, as is discussed, or after the finalization of audit report, if the information is obtained before the audit report, then the auditor should communicate with those charged with governance how the audit plan to address the material misstatement in the auditor's report, or withdrawal of the engagement if possible. And if the annual report or other information is received after the finalization of audit report and there is material misstatement in other information, then the auditor should take appropriate action that is legal, right, and obligation available to auditor to seek if the annual report is obtained after the audit report date and there exists a material misstatement in other information, the auditor should take appropriate action, and not corrected by charged with governance. In that case, auditor should take legal action. Auditor should exercise his legal rights and obligation to ensure that uncorrected material misstatement is appropriately brought to the attention of the users to whom the audit report is prepared. So, if annual report is obtained after the balance sheet date and there exists a material misstatement in other information and those charged with governance is not corrected, the auditor should exercise his legal rights and obligation to make sure that the material misstatement comes to the attention of the user of the organization to whom audit report is made available.